Welcome to BANKERSADDA. Today is day 23 of Kar IBPS 2019 FATEH. Aaj ki file alphanumeric series based hai. Directions 1 to 5. Study the following alphanumeric series carefully and answer the questions given below. Question number 1. How many consonants in the above series are immediately preceded and followed by symbols? The consonants followed by symbols and preceded by symbols. ऐसा कॉम्बिनेशन हमें देखना है तो अगर पहला कॉम्बिनेशन देखें तो क्लियरली एक तो ये है ये और दूसरा कॉम्बिनेशन देखें तो एक तो है ये इसके अलावा और देखें तो ऐसा कॉम्बिनेशन नहीं है इसलिए दो ही है आंसर ऑप्शन सी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 व्हिच एलिमेंट इज फोर्थ टू द राइट ऑफ द एलिमेंट व्हिच इज एट्थ फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट एंड सो एट From the left end, and fourth to the right, जो कि clearly हुआ 12th from the left, जो कि clearly है ये symbol, इसलिए option B हमारा correct answer है. Question number 3. What is the exact number of vowels between the 8th element from the left and 15th from the left? So 8th from the left hai ye aur 15th from the left hai ye. How many exact number of vowels are there between the 8th element from the left and the 15th element from the left? तो क्लियरली कोई भी वॉवल नहीं है इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 व्हाट वुड कम एट द क्वेश्चन मार्क इन द फॉलोइंग सीक्वेंस नाउ बी दिस सिंबल एंड डब्ल्यू 7 डब्ल्यू एंड एक्स डी 3 एंड परसेंटेज का सिंबल तो क्लियरली एक एलिमेंट छोड़ा हुआ है तो नेक्स्ट जो होगा वो होगा ई 3 एंड आई दैट इज ऑप्शन ई 3 एंड आई दैट इज ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर चलते हैं नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन पे क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 हाउ मेनी नंबर्स आर देयर इन द अबव सीरीज व्हिच आर फॉलोड बाय नंबर्स एंड प्रीसीडेड बाय वॉवल्स सो नंबर्स फॉलोड बाय नंबर्स एंड प्रीसीडेड बाय वॉवल्स तो अगर देखें तो ऐसा कोई भी कॉम्बिनेशन नहीं है इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है डायरेक्शन 6 to 10 स्टडी द सेट ऑफ नंबर्स गिवन बिलो एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच फॉलो सो नंबर है हमारे पास 5 नंबर्स हैं 3 डिजिट के Question number 6. Which of the following numbers will be obtained if the second digit of the lowest number is subtracted from the first digit of the largest number after subtracting 1 from each digit of each of the numbers? So, sabse lowest number kaun sa hai? Sabse lowest number hai hamara 858. Aur jo largest number hai, wo clearly hai 883. तो अगर पहले हमें माइनस वन करना है सारे डिजिट से एंड सेकेंड डिजिट ऑफ द लोएस्ट नंबर दैट इज 4 इज सब्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट डिजिट ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट नंबर दैट इज 7 तो क्लियरली 7 माइनस 4 दैट इज इक्वल्स टू 3 इसलिए ऑप्शन सी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 If in each number the first and the last digits are interchanged, then which of the following will be the third highest number? So, numbers mein interchange karte hain digits ko. First or last? 4, 6, 8, 3, 8, 8, 8, 6, 8, 7, 6, 8, 8, 5 and 8. So, third highest number, clearly hum dekh pa rahe hain, hoga ye. इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. इफ इन ईच नंबर द सेकंड एंड द फर्स्ट डिजिट्स आर इंटरचेंज देन व्हिच विल बी द हाईएस्ट नंबर. तो अगर इंटरचेंज करते हैं फर्स्ट एंड द सेकंड डिजिट, तो क्लियरली हमारा हाईएस्ट डिजिट जो है वो है ये, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 9. इफ वन इज सब्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट डिजिट ऑफ ईच ऑफ द नंबर्स and then first and third digits are interchanged, then which of the following will be the lowest? So, subtract karte hain first digit of each of the numbers se pehle. So, 764, 783, 768, 767 and 758. So, jo lowest number clearly hai, 758, jo ki 858 ka hai. इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. सॉरी, फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड डिजिट्स को हमें इंटरचेंज करना है. हमने सब्सट्रैक्ट कर दिया है, अब इंटरचेंज भी करना है. तो 467, 387, 867, 767 एंड 857. सो जो लोएस्ट नंबर है वो क्लियरली ये है, दैट इज 883. इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. इफ इन ईच नंबर ऑल द डिजिट्स आर अरेंज्ड इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर देन व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग विल बी द थर्ड लोएस्ट नंबर. तो थर्ड लोएस्ट नंबर अगर हमें डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर में अरेंज करना है, 864, 883, 886, 876 एंड 885. तो हाईएस्ट नंबर है ये, सेकंड हाईएस्ट नंबर है ये, और थर्ड हाईएस्ट नंबर है ये, जो कि थर्ड लोएस्ट भी है. इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन 11. विच एलिमेंट इज exactly midway between the 7th from the left end and 17th from the right end. So 7th from the left end clearly hai 9 and 17th from the right end hai clearly 6. So jo exactly midway hai wo hai 7. इसलिए ऑप्शन ई हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 12. हाउ मेनी परफेक्ट स्क्वायर्स आर देयर टू द राइट ऑफ द 10th एलिमेंट फ्रॉम द राइट एंड. सो 10th एलिमेंट फ्रॉम द राइट एंड जो कि है 7, और परफेक्ट स्क्वायर अगर हम देखें तो क्लियरली 4, 9 एंड 4. तो तीन परफेक्ट स्क्वायर्स हैं, इसलिए ऑप्शन सी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है, दैट इज 3. क्वेश्चन 13. हाउ मेनी परफेक्ट स्क्वायर्स आर देयर इन द अबव अरेंजमेंट ईच ऑफ विच इज इमीडिएटली प्रीसीडेड बाय एन इवन नंबर एंड इमीडिएटली फॉलोड बाय एन इवन नंबर. तो परफेक्ट स्क्वायर है एंड इवन डिजिट पहले भी होना चाहिए और इवन डिजिट बाद में भी होना चाहिए. तो अगर देखें तो क्लियरली एक है ये कॉम्बिनेशन, दूसरा है ये कॉम्बिनेशन, तीसरा कॉम्बिनेशन जो होगा वो है ये, चौथा कॉम्बिनेशन है ये. तो क्लियरली मोर देन 3 है, इसलिए ऑप्शन ई हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 14. हाउ मेनी परफेक्ट क्यूब्स आर देयर इन द अबव अरेंजमेंट ईच ऑफ व्हिच इज इमीडिएटली फॉलोड एंड प्रीसीडेड बाय एन ऑड नंबर. सो परफेक्ट क्यूब है एंड ऑड डिजिट बाद में भी होना चाहिए और पहले भी होना चाहिए. तो अगर देखें परफेक्ट क्यूब में होगा 1 एंड 8, तो 1 एंड 8 के आसपास हमें देखना है कौन सा कॉम्बिनेशन होगा जहां पे ऑड नंबर्स हैं दोनों साइड. एक है ये और दूसरा कॉम्बिनेशन नहीं है, एक ही कॉम्बिनेशन है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एलिमेंट इज फिफ्थ टू द राइट ऑफ 10th फ्रॉम द राइट एंड. सो 10th फ्रॉम द राइट एंड है, माइनस फिफ्थ फ्रॉम द राइट एंड है. तो क्लियरली फिफ्थ फ्रॉम द राइट एंड हमें निकालना है. जो कि क्लियरली 8 है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है.
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम डिस्कस करेंगे डे 23 ऑफ IBPS 2019 एग्जाम इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज क्विज. आज का जो हमारा क्विज है दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन कॉलम बेस्ड फिलर्स. कॉलम बेस्ड फिलर्स एक नए तरह के फिलर्स हैं जो IBPS क्लर्क मेंस में आए थे. हम इस पैटर्न के क्विजेस ऑलरेडी 2-3 बारी डिस्कस कर चुके हैं इन सीरीज में जो IBPS की सीरीज चल रही है अड्डा 247 पे. IBPS फतेह, उसमें हम 2-3 बारी इस तरह के क्विजेस डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. तो स्टार्ट करते हैं हमारे क्विज से. कॉलम बेस्ड फिलर्स हैं, ये नया पैटर्न है, इस बारी क्लर्क मेंस में आया था ये. कॉलम बेस्ड फिलर्स आपको कॉलम की फॉर्म में अपने आपको सॉल्यूशन दे रखे हैं, उन्होंने ऑप्शंस दे रखे हैं कॉलम के फॉर्म में. जो नए बच्चे हैं उनके लिए बता रहे हैं, कॉलम के बहुत फिलर्स दे रखे हैं ए बी सी एंड डी ई एफ. डबल फिलर्स होंगे ये, पूरे सेंटेंस में दो, पूरा जो आपका सेंटेंस है उसमें दो ब्लैंक्स होंगे. फर्स्ट ब्लैंक का आंसर आप फर्स्ट कॉलम में से लेंगे और जो सेकंड ब्लैंक का आंसर है उसका आप सेकंड ब्लैंक से लेंगे, सेकंड कॉलम से लेंगे. और आपको 5 ऑप्शंस दे रखे हैं, कॉम्बिनेशंस दे रखी हैं और आपको वो कॉम्बिनेशन में से सिलेक्ट करना है कौन सा कॉम्बिनेशन सही फिट बैठेगा ब्लैंक में. तो स्टार्ट करते हैं क्वेश्चन से. डायरेक्शंस 1 to 15. In the questions given below, a sentence is given with 2 blanks in each. Corresponding to each question, 2 columns are given with 3 words in each column. Which combination of words from the 2 columns will perfectly fit into the blanks to make the sentence contextually correct and meaningful? Grammatically, sentences sahi hai. Aapko contextually wo word fit karna hai. Aur grammar bhi dekhni hai ki jo word fit hoga, usse grammar sentence ki maintain ho. खराब ना हो. तो चेक करते हैं. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, जनरेशन गैप डैश व्हेन देयर इज अ कंसिडरेबल डिफरेंस ऑफ एज एंटायर जनरेशन डैश टू पीपल. तो फर्स्ट वाला देखते हैं, कॉलम 1 फर्स्ट ब्लैंक. फॉर्म व्हेन देयर इज अ कंसिडरेबल डिफरेंस. फॉर्म्स होता तो ठीक होता पर फॉर्म है यहां पर तो नहीं. अकर्स हो सकता है, यस. अकर्स व्हेन देयर इज अ कंसिडरेबल डिफरेंस, यस. क्रिएट, इस क्रिएट सही होता पर क्रिएट इटसेल्फ गलत है. तो बी फर्स्ट का आंसर हो गया. व्हेन देयर इज अ कंसिडरेबल डिफरेंस ऑफ एज एन एंटायर जनरेशन डैश टू पीपल बिटवीन, यस. दो लोगों के बीच में, यस. विद टू पीपल, नो. इनसाइड, नो. तो बी डी. अब देखते हैं कॉम्बिनेशन क्या है. ए ई, नो. ए एफ, सी ई, नो. ए ई ए एफ, सी ई सी एफ, नो. बी डी, यस. बी डी हमारा कॉम्बिनेशन है. तो आंसर इज डी. आप पहले अपना कॉम्बिनेशन बनाएंगे और स्ट्रेट अवे वो कॉम्बिनेशन पे टिक कर देंगे. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, व्हाइल जनरेशन गैप इज यूजुअली अ डैश ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन द चिल्ड्रन एंड देयर पेरेंट्स, इट इज डैश एन इंटरेस्टिंग कॉन्सेप्ट. फर्स्ट ब्लैंक इज यूजुअली अ डैश ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट. कॉज, यस, क्योंकि यहाँ कॉज की बात हो रही है, सही है. टेरिबल, नो. पॉइंट्स, नो. पॉइंट होता तो सही होता. तो ए हो गया हमारा फर्स्ट. बिटवीन द चिल्ड्रन एंड देयर पेरेंट्स, इट इज डैश एन इंटरेस्टिंग कॉन्सेप्ट. अमेज, नो. मोर, इट इज मोर एन इंटरेस्टिंग कॉन्सेप्ट, नो. एक्चुअली ये सही है. तो ए एफ देखते हैं. यस, फर्स्ट आंसर ही. तो आंसर इज ए. Question number three, money is the most basic requirement of life without which one cannot dash his basic needs and requirements of the daily dash. Cannot dash his basic requirements, desire की बात नहीं हो रही है क्योंकि needs की यहाँ बात है. Needs आप desire नहीं करेंगे, आप उनको fill करेंगे. Made, no. Fulfill, yes. C. Requirements of the daily रूटीन, यस. डेली रूटीन हो सकता है. प्रेजेंट, नो. वर्किंग, नो. वर्क होता तो ठीक होता. तो सी डी हमारा स्ट्रेट यही है. आंसर इज डी. अ गुड लीडर डैश टू अंडरस्टैंड द स्ट्रेंथ्स एंड वीकनेसेस ऑफ पीपल इन हिज टीम एज वेल एज देयर सिचुएशन इन ऑर्डर टू ब्रिंग डैश द बेस्ट इन देम. अ गुड लीडर डैश ट्राइज, यस. Helped, help होता तो ठीक होता. Manage, manages होता तो ठीक होता. तो A हो गया first. As well as their situation in order to bring dash the best in them. In, no. In the best in them नहीं होगा. Out, yes. Within, no. Answer is AE. AE A है. Answer is A. No matter how close you are to your team and how much you dash a two-way communication, those who look up to you often make you sit on a pedestal and this can lead to a dash of isolation. How much you dash a two-way enthusiasm, no. Encourage, yes. Pamper, no. Pamper nahi aayega yahan par. This can lead to a dash of isolation. Sense, yes. Sense, ठीक है. Sense, क्योंकि एक feeling की बात हो रही है. Freedom, no. Assure, no. Answer is B, D. B, D हमारा ये रहा. B, answer is B. Earlier newspapers were dashed with only new details, but currently they contain news and views about various subjects covering dash everything. Were dashed with only new details published? Yes, creation, created होता तो ठीक होता. Print, printed होता तो ठीक होता. कि past में चल रहा है sentence, तो answer यहाँ पर A होगा. Covering dash everything, since, no. More, no. Almost, yes, almost सही है. AF, AF E है. Answer is In this modern time when people do not have time to dash about things other than their job, newspapers let them know dash days and dates of the fairs, festival occasions, cultural events, etc. Calculate about things other than their job, no. No. Yes. Prediction, predict hota to theek hota. B, theek hai yahan par. Let them know dash days of their fairs. Know about, yes. Know with, no. Among, no. B, D. Answer is B. Private banks have their own call centers that are dashed towards answering the queries of the customers, dashed to their complaints and taking service requests. That are educates, no. Highlighted, no. Dedicated, yes. Dedicated, क्योंकि यहाँ dedicated towards ठीक है. सी अधियरिंग. यस. यहाँ पर किसी चीज की तरफ डेडिकेटेड अधियरिंग मतलब ठीक है. इग्नोरिंग नो. अपहोल्ड्स नो. तो ए डी तो सी डी. यस सी डी है हमारा आंसर. आंसर इज डी. Scientists have been trying to dash evidences to figure out whether life has never existed on Mars or is it inhabited with people presently or if there is any dash of life on Mars in the future. Trying to collate evidences. Yes, collate matlab collect. Collate ka matlab hota hai collect. Sahi hai. Separation no. Culminate no. Culminate conclusion pe aana no. ए तो है ही. इफ देर इज एनी फिगर नो. प्रेडिक्ट. प्रेडिक्ट ऑफ लाइफ नो. पॉसिबिलिटी. यस पॉसिबिलिटी की यहां बात हो रही है. ए एफ. ए एफ है हमारा आंसर. आंसर इज ई. व्हाइल द साइंटिस्ट कीप सेंडिंग स्पेस क्राफ्ट एंड रोवर्स ऑन मार्स टू डैश देयर रिसर्च आई ऑफन ड्रीम अबाउट गोइंग टू द प्लैनेट टू अंडरस्टैंड इफ देयर आर एनी पीपल लिविंग देयर एंड डैश लाइफ इज एक्चुअली पॉसिबल ऑन दिस प्लैनेट और नॉट. इंड्यूसेस देयर सर्च नो. कंडक्ट देयर सर्च क्योंकि कुछ रिसर्च कंडक्ट होती है. यस. कर्ब नो. कर्ब मतलब बंद कर देना. नो तो बी तो है ही. वेदर. Yes, weather मतलब if, शायद. Yes, weather, weather मतलब climate, climate की बात नहीं हुई है. Rather, no. B, D. Answer is B. A perceptible process of transformation has dashed in education away from a lecture-based dash approach and towards adaptable, flexible modes of learning and teaching. Has dash in education developed hota to theek hota. Introduced hota to theek hota. Began. Yes, began theek hai yahan par. Didactic ye theek hota kyunki teaching method ki baat ho rahi hai. Didactic ka matlab इन्फॉर्मेशन. नॉट लेक्चर बेस्ड इंफॉर्मेशन अप्रोच ये गलत है. इम्प्रूविंग नो. आंसर इज सी डी. आंसर इज डी. एजुकेशनल रिफॉर्म्स कैन प्ले एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन डैश वायलेंस अगेंस्ट वुमेन बाई इंक्रीजिंग स्कूल सेफ्टी बाई एम्पावरिंग वुमेन थ्रू एजुकेशन एंड बाई डैश बेटर एटीट्यूड्स एंड प्रैक्टिसेस अमंग स्टूडेंट्स अबाउट वुमेन्स human rights. Play an important role in violence. Preventing. Yes. Preventing. ठीक है. Intercepting. No. Preventing. Yes. Endangering. No. And by dash better attitudes. Yes. Promoting. ठीक है. Revise. No. Editing. No. The answer is BD. A है हमारा answer. Straightforward यहाँ पर. Answer is A. Violence against women and girls is related to their dash of power and control as well as to the social norms that prescribe men and women's role in society and dash abuse. So their lack of power, yes. Hinder, no. Ability, no. Condone, yes. Overlook bhi ho sakta hai. कंडोन का भी मतलब होता है किसी गलत चीज को सपोर्ट करना. ओवरलुक का मतलब भी होता है नजरअंदाज करना. तो ठीक है दोनों का मतलब यहाँ ठीक होगा. रिग्रेट नो. तो बी ए के साथ डी का कॉम्बिनेशन भी बन सकता है. ए के साथ ई का कॉम्बिनेशन भी फिट बैठेगा. तो आंसर इज ई. आंसर इज ई. Women education is necessary because if a woman is educated, she would be able to dash herself for rights, fight against discrimination, able to take decision concerning herself, dash to economic growth of nation, will be able to face all scientific and technological changes, and will participate in world politics. Introduce self to her rights, introduce herself for her rights. Yes. ये गलत है. Introduce नहीं आएगा यहाँ पर. Introduce for her rights, no. Empower, yes. Empower, ठीक है. Encourage, no. Contribute herself dash to economic growth. Contribute, सही है. Distribute, no. Produce, no. तो BD है इसका answer. Answer is D. Globalization and the internet dash change every aspect of the tourism and leisure industry. From marketing and communication channels dash booking and hospitality services have changed. Yes, do cheeze hain. Has, no. Had, no. Channels in booking and hospitality services. From ke saath in nahi aayega yahan par kyunki इस चीज से उस चीज तक की बात हो रही है तो ये गलत है. टू ठीक है, फोर गलत है. आंसर इज तो ए ई है इसका आंसर. तो गाइस ये था हमारा डिस्कशन ऑफ डे 23 फॉर आईबीपीएस एग्जाम. थैंक यू.
गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. Today we are going to discuss quantitative aptitude quiz based on 3D mensuration for IBPS. Okay, so today is day 22 for CAR IBPS 2019 FATEH. Okay, now the topic is 3D mensuration, which is discussed in the title of the quiz. Okay, so now we'll move on questions. In the first question, if the height of a cylinder is 4 times its base circumference, the volume of the cylinder in terms of its base circumference C is. Okay, so height of cylinder is given. This is a cylinder. This is the height and this is the radius. Okay, so this height is 4 times of this circumference, that is perimeter of circle. Okay, that is h is equal to 4 into 2 pi r. If radius of base is r, then this is 8 pi r. Okay, and the volume is c, given in the question. C is pi r square h. This is the volume of cylinder. So from here pi value of r in terms of h will be h upon 8 pi. So this will be pi h upon 8 pi square into h. This will be from here this will be pi into h square upon 64 pi square into h. Okay, so or we can say from here value of h, or we can put value of h. So this will be pi, 7 pi cancel. This is 1 upon 64 pi and this is h cube. Okay, so from here this will be 1 upon 64 pi and value of h is 2 pi r into 4 cube. Okay, so here this is here C is the base circumference. Sorry, C is the base circumference. So 2 pi r means C. So this is 1 upon 64 pi into C CQ into 64. Okay, so 64 cancel, and this is CQ upon pi. Okay, so this is the volume of cylinder V in terms of base circumference C. CQ upon pi, so this is the right answer. And if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question. Sorry, this is B. Question number second. In the second question, if the height of a given cone be doubled and radius of the base remains the same, the ratio of the volume of the given cone to that of the second cone will be. So first cone, let's first cone C1, this is height of first cone is H1, and radius R, this is same in both case, and in second case height becomes double, that is 2H1, and radius same. Okay, radius of the base remains same. So C1 by C2, that is volume of first cone to the volume of second cone, this will be 1 by 3 pi r square h1, and this is 1 by 3 pi r square h2. So these are the common, so cancelled, h1 by h2, so h1, and h value of h2 is 2h1, so this is 2h1, so 1 is 2, 2. Okay, so the ratio of volume will be 1 is to 2, and if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay, directly इसको directly भी solve कर सकते हैं, but here ये formula मैंने इसलिए बताया ताकि जिन लोगों को नहीं पता हो जान जाएं कि volume of cone is 1 by 3 times pi r square h. directly सिर्फ यहाँ पे height में change हो रहा है, second cone का height जो है first cone के height का दुगना हो रहा है, तो directly volume का ratio जो होगा 1 is to 2 हो जाएगा, because all the remaining other quantities are same. So, एक required ratio will be 1 is to 2. Okay, next question, question number third. In the third question, the numerical values of the volume and the area of the lateral surface of a right circular cone are equal. Okay, if the height of the cone be h and radius be r, the value of 1 upon h square plus 1 upon r square is. Here, numerical values of the volume and the area of the lateral surface of a right circular cone are equal. So here volume of cone as given in question is equal to lateral surface area in numerical values, because unit of both is different. So in numerical value these are same, so volume of cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h, and lateral surface area pi r l. Okay, where l is the lateral height, that is r square plus h square. Okay, so from here pi pi cancel, 1 r r cancel, that is h by r h by 3, this is equal to L, and value of L is R square plus H square, squaring both sides, this is R square H square by 9, and this is R square plus H square. Okay, so this will be R square plus H square upon R square H square, this is equal to 1 upon 9. Okay, so from here this is 1 upon h square, and this is 1 upon r square, is equal to 1 upon 9. Okay, so the required answer is 1 upon 9, and that is option D. So D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number fourth. In the fourth question, a sphere of radius r is cut by a plane at a distance of h from its center, thereby breaking this sphere into two different pieces. The cumulative surface area of these two pieces is 25% more than that of the sphere. Find h. Okay, so this is a sphere and this is cut. Suppose here it is cut in two different parts, one is small part, another is larger part. Okay, so here this is the center so suppose this is like this. Okay, so and this is the so this is the h as given in question. From center this is distance h, and suppose radius of r1, radius of cut piece, जो पीस कट हुआ है स्मॉलर पीस उसका जो रेडियस है वो r1 है. ओके, एंड दिस इज द रेडियस ऑफ होल स्फीयर. r इज द रेडियस ऑफ होल स्फीयर, और वी कैन से रेडियस ऑफ स्फीयर, नॉर्मली रेडियस ऑफ स्फीयर. ओके, नाउ न्यू सरफेस एरिया, or we can say surface area of two pieces. Surface area of two pieces is 125% of total surface area of the sphere, that is 4 pi r square. So this will be 5 pi r square. Okay, so increased surface area, or we can say increment in surface area is equal to 5 pi r square minus 4 pi r square, that is pi r square, and this is due to cut of sphere, that is due to these two circular parts a sphere ka surface area increase ho gaya, because there are two small circular parts. Okay, so let from here circumference, or we can say area of each circular part will be, each small circular part, or we can say each circular part, area of each circular part will be pi r square by 2. Okay, and if r1 is the radius of circular part, then area will be pi r1 square. Okay, so from here r1 will be equal to r by root 2. Okay, now if you take this triangle separately, that is this is h, this is r1 and this is r, this is r1, this is h and this is r. Okay, so from here h will be r square minus r1 square. This is a right angle triangle. So from here r square and r1 square is equal to r square by 2, that is r by root 2. This is a value of h. Okay, so h is equal to r by root 2, and if you look at options, a will be the right option. Okay, so this is a good question. Now we'll move on next question, question number 5. In the fifth question, two right circular cylinders of equal volume have their heights in the ratio of 1:2. The ratio of their radii is, here volume is equal, V1 is equal to V2, and ratio of height, that is H1, H2, this is the 1:2. So volume of cylinder is, volume of cylinder is pi r square h. So here V1 upon V2 will be equal to pi R1 square H1 pi R2 square H2. Here V1 V2 is equal, so this is 1:1, or we can say R1 square H1 is equal to R2 square H2. From here R1 square upon R2 square, this is equal to H2 by H1, okay, or R1 upon R2, this is square root of H2 by H1, so H2 by H1 is 2 by 1, that is root 2 by 1, okay. So this is the required ratio of radius of a sphere, that is root 2 is to 1, okay. So A will be the right option. Okay, next question. Question number 6th. In the 6th question, the radius of base and curved surface area of right cylinder R units and 4 pi RH square units respectively. Okay, so radius of right cylinder is R and curved surface area is 4 pi RH. The height of the cylinder is, that is H is what? Okay. So here curved surface area radius of cylinder is given, radius of cylinder, that is R, and curved surface area CSA, curved surface area of cylinder is also given, 4 pi RH. Okay, so as we know, curved surface area of cylinder 2 pi R into height. Okay, so here 2 pi R into height will be equal to, that is height of cylinder, this is equal to 4 pi R H. From here 2 pi, pi pi cancel, R cancel, and this is 2, that is height is equal to 2 H. Okay, so height of cylinder is equal to 2 H, and if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question. Question number 7th. In the 7th question, if the area of the base, height and volume of a prism be 3 root 3 by 2 P square centimeter square, 100 root 3 centimeter and 7200 cube centimeter respectively, then the value of P in centimeter will be, okay. So here volume of prism is equal to area of base into height, that is height of prism. So volume of prism is given 7200, area base is given 3 root 3 by 2 P square, and height is also given 100 root 3. Okay, so from here this is P square into 3 root 3 into root 3, that is 9, so 9, and this is equal to 144. So P square is equal to 16. So P is equal to 4. Okay, 4 centimeter. So the value of P is 4. And if you look at options, A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 8. In the 8th question, the base of a right prism is a quadrilateral ABCD. Given that AB is 9 cm, BC is 14 cm, CD is 13 cm, DA is 12 cm and DAB, angle DAB is 90 degree. If the volume of the prism be 2070 cube centimeter, then the area of the lateral surface is, that is ABCD. So this is A and this is like this A, B, this is 9 centimeter and BC, BC is, BC is 14 centimeter and CD is 13 centimeter this is D and DA 12 centimeter so this is 12 this is 13 okay now angle DAB angle DAB is 90 degree okay so angle DAB 90 degree it means this will be the angle DAB 90 degree So this is 90 degree. Okay. So this will be the hypotenuse of this triangle ABD. So this is will be square root of 12 square plus 9 square. That is 144 plus 81. This is 225. Okay, so this is equal to 15. So this is 15. Okay, now what is asked? Area of lateral surface. So area of lateral surface, that is area of triangle ABD. Area of triangle ABD. This is 1 by 2 base into height. So this is AB into AD. So 9 into 12, that is 6, 9 into 6, 54 square centimeter. Okay. And triangle BCD. This is triangle BCD. In triangle BCD S, that is semi perimeter will be equal to sum of sides divided by 2, that is 15 plus 14 plus 13, this is 13 divided by 2, so this will be 4 5 9 3 12 1 1 1 1 1 2 1 3 and 1 4 1 2, that is 21 centimeter. Okay, so the area will be, as you know, a formula also for area, area of triangle BCD, this will be square root of S minus A, S minus B and S minus C, where S is the semi perimeter of the triangle and ABC are the sides of the triangle. So this is 21 and this is 21 minus A, A suppose 14, so 21 minus 14 and 21 minus B is 13, so 13 and 21 minus 15. So this will be 21, this is 7, this is 8 and this is 6. So from here we can write this 7 into 7 into 3, okay, and this is 8 and this is 3 into 2, okay. So this is pair of 7, this is pair of 3, and 8 into 2 is 16, that is square of 4. So this will be 7 into 3 into 4, that is 4 into 3 12, 12 into 7 84. So 84 square centimeter, this is the area of triangle BCD, and the area of triangle ABD is 54 centimeter square. Now here area of total area of quadrilateral will be area of quadrilateral ABCD. This will be summation of these two, that is 54 plus 84, 448 and 8513 square centimeter. This is the area of base of the prism, okay, and the height of the prism, height of prism will be, as we know, volume of prism is area of base into height, okay. So from here h will be volume upon area of base, so volume is given as 2070 and area of base is 138, that is 138. If we solve this, this will be equal to 15 centimeter, okay. Now this is the height of the prism. Then lateral surface area is, so lateral surface area will be, suppose this is base of prism, so suppose this will be like this, okay. So there are four triangles on this prism, that is this one triangle, this, and second is this, third will be this, and fourth will be this and this, okay, or we can say this and this, okay. So perimeter of base will be summation of all the sides, so perimeter of base for lengthy question ho gaya, perimeter of base, that is summation of side, so 9 12 13 9 12 13 and 14, so this will be 48. Summation of these all will be 9 plus 14 plus 13 plus 12, this will be equal to 48 centimeter, okay. So area of lateral surface, area of lateral surface, area of lateral surface will be perimeter into height, so perimeter is 48 and height is 15, so this will be 48 into 15, that is 720 square centimeter. So this is the required answer, 720 square centimeter, okay. So this is the lateral surface area of the prism, okay. Now if you look at options, A will be the right option. Here unit is wrong, this is not cube centimeter, this is square centimeter, okay. So A will be the right option, okay. Next question, say thoda lengthy question tha, do teen concept isme the. Now question one, ninth, if the slant height of a right pyramid with square base is 4 meter and the total slant surface of the pyramid is 12 square centimeter, then the ratio of total slant surface and right area of the base is, okay, this is the base of pyramid. Okay. Okay, so this is the base of the pyramid, that is square base. And these are the this is the complete pyramid. Okay, this will be in 3D. This is the height of the pyramid. This is the height of the pyramid. Okay, and these sides will be equal, that is this will be triangle like this on each side. Four triangle yahan banenge base pe like this. This side will be equal and this is the side of the base, square base. Okay, so suppose this is A. Now slant height of the right pyramid with square base is 4 meter. That is, this is 4. So this is also 4. Okay. And total slant surface of the pyramid is 12 square centimeter. So total slant surface will be, if side of base is A, then slant area of one triangle will be height into 1 by 2, base into height, that is total slant surface. This will be 4 times, because there are 4 triangle, 4 times 1 by 2 side of base, that is A, and height, that is H. Okay. So here this is 12 and this is 4 into 1 by 2 into A. Sorry, this is slant height. So slant height of base is given, or you can say slant height of prism is given. This is 4. Okay, that is slant height, not H, slant height. So this is 4. Now from here this will be 3 and this is 2. So A is equal to 3 by 2 centimeter. This is the side of the base. So area of base will be, this is square base, so A square, that is 9 by 4 square centimeter. This is the area of base. So required ratio will be ratio of total slant surface and area of base. So total slant surface is 12, that is 12 divided by 9 by 4. So this is 12 into 4 upon 9. This is 3, this is 4. That is 16:3. Okay, so this is the ratio of total slant surface and area of the base. Now if you look at options, A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 10th. In the 10th question, the perimeter of the triangular base of right prism is 15 centimeter and the radius of the in circle of the triangular base is 3 cm. If the volume of the prism is 270 cube centimeter, then height of the prism is, okay, so this is the base of prism. okay, and this is a in circle. Okay, this is in circle. Now base of the prism is 15 centimeter, so that is perimeter of this triangle is 15 centimeter. Okay, so perimeter is given 15 centimeter, so semi perimeter will be 15 by 2 centimeter. This is S. Okay, and R, this is the radius R. R is equal to area of triangle, that is A delta, divided by semi perimeter, where delta is the, or we can say triangle is the area of triangle. Area of triangle ABC, suppose this is ABC, so area of triangle ABC. Okay, now R is given 3 centimeter, so from here area will be, area of triangle will be R, that is 3, and semi perimeter 15 by 2, so this is 45 by 2 square centimeter. Okay, so this is the area of triangle. So volume of prism will be, volume of prism, area base, area base into height, so area base is 45 by 2, and height is h, and volume of prism is given in the question, 270 cube centimeter, so from here h will be 270 into 2 divided by 45. From here this is 54 0 45, this is 5, this is 60, so this is 12 centimeter. Okay, so the height of the prism is 12 centimeter, that is D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 11th. In the 11th question, if the radii of the circular ends of a truncate conical bucket which is 45 cm high be 28 cm and 7 cm, then the capacity of the bucket in cubic centimeter is. Okay, so here volume of bucket, volume of bucket will be 1 by 3 pi, and R square capital R small r square plus R capital R small r into h. This is the formula for volume of truncate conical bucket with circular ends. Okay, so from here height is 45 centimeter and capital R 28 centimeter, small r is 7 centimeter, so this will be 1 by 3 pi, means by 22 by 7, and h is 45. Okay, r is 28, so 28 is square, and small r is 7, so 7 is square, and 28 into 7. Okay, if you solve this, this is 15, so this is 22 by 7 into 15 into, if you solve this, this is 784, square of 28 is 784, and this is 49, and this is 28 into 7, 7 into 8 56, 5 remainder, 7 into 14 and 5 1 9. Okay, that is 196. So this is 6 4 10 9 19. This is 8 4 12 12 9 21 21 1 22 and 7 1 8 8 2 10. So this is 1029. So this is 1029. From here, this is 22 into 15, and this is 1. So 1029 when divided by 7, 1 7 3 2 4 4 9, that is 7. So this is 147. And if we multiply these three, we will find 48 510 cube centimeter. Okay, so this is the capacity of the bucket, 48 510 cube centimeter. And if you look at options, 48 510, that is option A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 12. In the 12th question, the radii of the base of two cylinders A and B are in the ratio of 3:2 and their heights in the ratio of x:1. If the volume of cylinder A is 3 times that of cylinder B, then the volume value of x is. So here volume of cylinder is, volume of cylinder, this is pi r square h, where r is the radius of base and h is the height of cylinder. So V1, or we can say VA, is the 3 times of VB. So from here VA upon VB will be 3:1. So VA will be pi RA square HA, and VB will be pi RB square HB. This is equal to 3:1. From here radius are in the ratio 3:2. So RA upon RB, RA upon RB square into H, HA upon HB is equal to 3:1. From here RA upon RB 3:2. So this will be 9/4, and HA upon HB is x:1, and this is equal to 3/1. So here 3, so value of x is 4/3. Okay, so here A will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 13th. In the 13th question, if the length of each side of a regular tetrahedron is 12 centimeter, then the volume of the tetrahedron is. Okay, so here formula for volume of tetrahedron. Okay, this is a formula, that is a cube side of tetrahedron upon 6√2. Okay, this is the formula for volume of tetrahedron, regular tetrahedron. So from here A is the side, and this is 12 centimeters, so 12 cube upon 6√2. So 12 is 1728 divided by 6√2. So this will be 1728 into √2, and this is 12. So this is 144√2. Okay, so this is the volume of tetrahedron. And if you look at options, A will be the right option, that is 144√2. Okay, next question, question number 14th. In the 14th question, the height of a circular cylinder is increased 6 times and the base area is decreased to 1/9 of its value. the factor by which the lateral surface of the cylinder increases is. Height of circular cylinder is increased 6 times. So initial height initial height is h, new height becomes increased 6 times, that is 6h, and the base area is decreased to 1/9 of its value. So initial base area is pi r square, okay, for cylinder, this is cylinder. So this is the base area, that is pi r square, okay, and new base area is decreased to 1/9 of its value, that is pi r square upon 9th. The factor by which the lateral surface of the cylinder increases is. So lateral surface is 2 pi rh, and this is the formula for lateral surface. Now in this if you calculate new radius and new height, so new height is 6h and new radius will be pi r1 square. So pi cancels, so r1 will be r by 3, okay. So new lateral surface area will be 2 pi r1 is r by 3, so this is r by 3 and h is 6h, so this is 6h, that is 2, so this is 2 into 2 pi rh, okay. The factor by which the lateral surface of the cylinder increases is. So this is the initial surface and this is the factor by which new surface increases. So this is equal to 2, that is by factor 2 the new lateral surface increases. So here A will be the right option. Okay, next question. Question number 15. In the 15th question, if the radius of a cylinder is decreased by 50% and the height is increased by 50% to form new cylinder, the volume will be decreased by. Okay, so radius of cylinder is decreased by 50%, that is initial radius r, say r by 2, and height is increased, and that is h, say 3h by 2, okay. So initial volume v1 pi r square h, and new volume v2 pi r by 2 square into h, that is 3h by 2. From here this is pi r square h, okay, and this is 1 by 4, and this is 3 by 2, so this will be 3 by 8 pi r square h, okay. So here decrement in volume will be initial volume, that is v1 minus v2. V2 is 3 by 8 v1, so 3 by 8 v1 divided by v1 into 100, this will be 5 by 8 into 100, and this is 12.5. so this will be 5 into 12.5, that is 62.5%, okay. So decrement in the volume will be 62.5%. so if you look at options, C will be the right option, okay. So this is the end of this क्वांटिटेटिव एप्टीट्यूड क्विज बेस्ड ऑन 3D मेंसुरेशन. आई होप आप लोगों को पसंद आया होगा. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर लिसनिंग मी एंड बेस्ट ऑफ लक फॉर योर एग्जाम्स.